Alright guys, so recently I picked up a box full of PlayStation stuff, and guess what? What's inside? Ooh, a really nice old racing wheel. Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. It's awesome that you're tuning in. So in this video, we are going to take a close look at an old racing wheel from Logitech. What I like about it, that it is for your old school PlayStation 2, but also you can use it on a PC, or we're going to use it for today. Okay, so this thing is basically made for the PlayStation 2, but because of the USB and compatibility with Windows 10, we can use it with many games. For example, Project Cars as a support perfectly for the system and in combination with this piece of hardware. Okay, but what I like about this racing wheel, because it's very old, don't get me wrong, this is still using, by the way, this 24 volt Logitech racing adapter. They're using these things for ages now. Comes with just a barrel jack connection. But what I like about this particular racing wheel, it's like it's a high-end racing wheel for back in the day. And what you can expect is you're going to get a really cool performance. And what do I mean with performance? So first of all, this thing doesn't have the full rotation that you have like with the new Logitech racing wheels. But you can already feel like the force feedback is just the next level. And with next level, I have used a lot of these racing wheels. So for example, the high-end stuff had like very nice leather wheels. This is made of rubber, but not like the rubber that will get sticky. And then it's a lot of plastic, fantastic. This is, by the way, made from aluminum or something like that. It comes with a floating D-pad and two LEDs for indication when the system has been activated. And yep, you can see like the second LED will start blinking and you can hear the force feedback clicking in when it started to work. But okay, so here we're going to get the shifter, something you don't have very often with cheap wheels. The kind of weird is like the plus is backwards, like going up in shifts, kind of weird. But you can change it out sometimes in the software. It still have like a similar Logitech attachment when you need to put it on your table. I really like it. It's again plastic fantastic, but it works like a charm. Alright, so at the back we're going to get the connection for the pedal to put the pedal to the metal, and then we're going to get the input for the barrel jack connection, 24 volts. So also with the pedals, it looks in very nice condition. I did clean it up a little bit, and the pedals, they feel different. Like you can see like the brake have a different spring. So for an old, say racing wheel with pedals, it's very professional and I do like it. There is no clutch, but if you don't mind it, it's not a big of a deal. Still have the same connection like the later models. Okay, so at the bottom, what you can see over here, we're going to get all the stuff that we're going to get with the latest G25, G107. And we're going to get the rubber for the grip, but also the grip for when you're having a carpet. So quite interesting for an old racing wheel. We got a lot of great goodies. Okay, so let's plug it in my machine and you can see like it's doing his test. So he's going to calibrate the wheel. And when I'm booting up the game, both of the LEDs will start turning on. So now you can see like it's turned on, plugged in. But when you're booting up the game, you can hear a click. And after the click, it basically activates with the game itself. And it's ready to go. So take consideration, not all racing wheels in combination with games will have perfect, let's say, compatibility. But with Project Cars, number one, you see the Logitech Driving Force Pro with separate pedals. It works like a charm. And with this game, it works very well. So let's play some games and let's have some fun. you can find this thing very cheap, I think you will have like a really cool experience. Of course, it has its limitations compared with the G25, but still, it's a very nice racing wheel in 2021. Let me know what you think of this. I want to thank you for watching. Consider subscribing, hit that little bell, become one of the Wicked family, and I will see you in the next video.